Hello everyone. In my first part, I taught you that if the colors dry up, you have to put little water inside it and close the lid for 5-6 hours or 2-3 days. And then when you open it after 2-3 days or 5-6 hours, you will still find water on top of it. That doesn't mean that it has not converted into a pulp. You just have to put the handle of the brush like this and move very hard. The whole color inside the bottle will convert into a pulp, and this is how it has to be done. Or you can take a stick also to do this work, and to check whether your brush is of a good quality, dip the brush in water and rotate it like this. And if the hairs come to a point, this shows that the brush is of a good quality. Now we are applying thin layers, so we have to take the color from the bottle inside the palette. So I have used the ice tray of the kitchen because thin colors, if you mix a lot of water, might mix inside the palette only. So separate compartments are given so it won't get mixed up. So let us start with the thin layer first. Remember, the layers on the paper, when you apply, they have to be completely dry when you apply the next layer on top of it. Otherwise, there are chances that the colors might mix. This can happen with the thin layer also, and this can happen with the thick layer which you apply also. The colors might mix. The mixing of the colors, if you want, that is the merging, then easy it is for you to mix or apply two layers and merge them on paper. More than two layers means there are chances that you might get a muddy appearance. So it is a big risk to apply the third layer also. But if you want, you can take this risk with the third layer, but not beyond that. Once the colors dry up, then you have to apply the other layer, the darker layers or the lighter layers on the lighter tones itself. And you will realize, see, the mixing or merging of the colors do not take place. And then this can be done if you dry up the layers on paper. This can be done with many layers and the colors will be as fresh as ever. But if you mix wet layers, then it is possible that you are able to only mix two layers. The third one is a risk in both the thick and thin. So see, once the colors dry up, the effect is totally different. Now, sometimes the thick layers can be applied even when you don't allow the layers on paper to dry up completely, provided you don't move the brush again and again on the color. And the strokes also have to be very carefully done, and if that kind of a method